Hand washing is one of the most important ways you can keep from getting sick and spreading germs to others. Dirty hands spread disease. This hand washing demonstration will show you how hand washing can get rid of germs and chemicals that get on our hands every day. This gel is like the germs and chemicals that we get from things we touch throughout the day, like our toys and pets. If we then rub our eyes, nose, or mouth, or pick up something to eat, the germs or chemicals can get into our bodies and make us sick. Studies have shown that people touch their eyes, nose, and mouth about 25 times every hour without even realizing it. To get rid of these germs and chemicals, CDC recommends you follow these easy steps every time you wash your hands. Wet, lather, scrub, rinse, and dry. We're going to show you the right way to do each step. First, wet your hands with clean running water. Turn off the tap and apply soap. Then, lather your hands by rubbing them together with the soap. Be sure to lather the backs of your hands between your fingers and under your nails. Scrub your hands for at least 20 seconds. If you don't have a clock nearby, keep scrubbing until you've sung the happy birthday song twice. Rinse your hands well under clean running water. Dry your hands using a clean towel, electric hand dryer, or air dry them. Washing your hands using the steps we just demonstrated is very important to get hands completely clean. Let's see how well we got rid of the germs and chemicals. Great! No more germs and chemicals. Why is this so important? Germs and chemicals from unwashed hands can get into our foods and drinks when they're being prepared or when we're eating or drinking them, which can make us sick. Also, germs and chemicals from unwashed hands can be transferred to other objects like cell phones, tabletops, or toys, and then transferred to other people's hands. That's why it's so important to wash your hands following these steps. Wet, lather, scrub, rinse, and dry so you can stay healthy and help keep those around you healthy. For more information, visit cdc.gov/handwashing.
Okay, so obviously there's a lot of crazy things going on in the world.
Yeah, so please stay safe, everyone, and please wash your hands.
And avoid having too much contact with your face.
Good quarter to noon, Pioneers. Today is Thursday,
March 12, 2020. Before we begin, we'd like to give a huge pile to a very special someone.
Her name is Alejandra Munoz, and today is her 18th birthday.
So if you see her, please wish her a very, very happy birthday.
Alexia, have you been taking care of the flower that I gave you for Valentine's Day?
I tried, but my cat destroyed it. Sorry.
Oh, well, I should have figured that was going to happen.
Well, you know what?
What?
In the words of Elsa from Frozen, do you want to plant a flower?
That's not what she said.
Well, I couldn't think of a way to introduce today's National Plant a Flower Day.
Oh my, wait, really? That's so cool.
Yeah, and I want to plant a flower with you.
Okay, well, we could do that later, but because we're talking about flowers, have you ever wanted to go see the flowers from Hawaii?
Yes, I heard that they are so, so pretty.
Me too, but I have a bit of a history lesson for you.
And what is it?
Today in history, in 1959, the U.S. House joined with the U.S. Senate in approving the statehood of Hawaii.
So today, Hawaii became the 50th state?
Yep, and we can thank the House and the Senate to make those beautiful islands a part of the U.S.
Well, now that I'm a little bit more educated about the U.S., we can head into our
Throwback Thursday!
Today's throwback is a junior currently sitting in Miss Rita's fourth period human anatomy class.
If you happen to be in that class as well, look around and use these scents to decipher who it might be.
She enjoys dancing.
And she's a music fanatic.
If you can't quite figure it out yet.
Well, we can't give you her name just yet.
But in the meantime, here's ours. I'm Kirsten.
And I'm Alexia.
And this is the Pioneer Press Daily Edition. Don't forget forget, seniors, the 2020 PTSA scholarship is due this week. Pick up an application at the Parent Center and submit no later than March 13th. It's a Friday.
Attention, pioneers. For all of you who still want to join ASB,
you still have time. The application deadline has been extended to today, so make sure you do not miss up on this amazing opportunity to become a part of the change of the school.
If you're interested, make sure to pick up an application at the ASB accounts office near the ASB room.
And attention all students.
Unfortunately, due to the small ticket sale, 80 Sadie's dance is canceled.
Sorry, bios. And since we're talking about signing up for things, sign up for the 3v3 basketball tournament.
The last day of signups is March 18th.
To sign up, you need at least one girl and one varsity player.
Did we also mention that it's free?
Sign up today.
And next week, we'll be having Spirit Week.
On Monday, wear your favorite meme or meme for Meme Madness.
Thursday, wear green for St. Patrick's Day.
And Wednesday is sportswear or jerseys.
Thursday is nighty night, so wear your PJs.
And on Friday, blueout. And seniors, don't forget to wear your crowns.
The current Spirit points are, for freshmen, 30.
Sophomores with 44.
Juniors with 48.
And seniors are in the lead with 54 points.
There will also be lunch activities that week. On Monday, there will be a water balloon game.
Tuesday is a donut eating contest.
And Wednesday is an obstacle course, so make sure you come out and participate.
Please come out. And for clubs and organizations, attention all pios, Dancing with the Staff is coming up Friday, March 20th, and let me tell you, it is something you do not want to miss.
We have 8 amazing staff members who will be battling out for the coveted mirror ball. Those who are participating will be Mr. Schubert,
Miss Hannah,
Mr. Jaramillo,
Miss Casto,
Miss Snow,
Mr. Layton,
Miss Kirby,
and Mr. Nava. We have the panel of Western Dance alumni and district dance teachers who will select the winner of the infamous mirror ball trophy. But you will have a say too.
Bring your spare change to put in the donation box for your favorite teams. The team with the most money at the end of intermission will receive the Viewer's Choice Award.
Come support these amazing staff stars and the West Creation Dance team at the show at 7 o'clock Friday, March 20th in the Forum.
See any dance team member for tickets, $8 pre-sale and $10 at the door.
See you there.
Looking for skills to pay the bills? Come by Havanza to help you with the skills you need to be successful in school, the workforce, and beyond.
You can find Avanza after school Monday through Friday in room 53, and this Saturday at Saturday Academy in room 21 as well.
You can also now text the code WHS Avanza
to the number 81010 to stay in the loop about Avanza reminders and updates.
First 100 students to sign up will be entered in an opportunity for a raffle for a gift card. Don't miss out.
And in sports, the boys volleyball team will be playing today against Santa Fe High School. The JV team will be playing at 3.
And the varsity boys volleyball team is playing today at 4.
And don't forget the boys varsity tennis team will be playing a home game today at 3 against Godinez.
Good luck, boys.
And hey, Pios, there will also be a varsity softball game today at Orange at 3:15.
Go and show your support. And track and field is having a meet today at Westminster.
Good luck, boys and girls.
And attention all students, the Western swimming team is now accepting new swimmers for this year's swim team.
Come out to the pool after school and sign up to join the Western swim team.
Swimming is a great way to get in good shape and to meet new friends.
Come be part of the fun and at the Western pool. Also, not to mention the swim team will be having a tournament tomorrow at Westminster, and the game starts at 3.
We hope to see you there.
Go Big Blue!
Well, that's all we have for today, Pios.
Wait!
What?
We are forgetting to reveal today's throwback.
Today's throwback is, drum roll please,
Melina Cabrera.
In 10 years, she sees herself as a social worker or a trauma surgeon.
And as for what she's up to currently, she loves to go to the beach and absolutely loves hanging out with her friends.
If you want to be featured as a wayback, throwback, or flashback, just like Melina,
or if you'd like to give a pie out to a club, sport, athlete, scholar, friend, teacher, or staff, like Alejandra,
we'd be happy to do so. Now, make sure you follow us on all your favorite social media platforms using at the Pio Press.
Keep hashtagging our pictures using hashtag Pio Press.
Thankful.
Driving.